Hi, there is a huge amount of looting materials on the dental market, but usually when fixing metal and porcelain fused to metal restorations, dentist automatically selects a glass ionomer cement, or as we will call it here and after, GIC, and the composite uses for ceramic. However, there is another class of materials, compomer. It's also a hybrid GIC, it's also a GIC of double curing, and it's also a GIC modified with a composite. In other words, a mix of GIC and a composite. This material was created to neutralize the weakness of the GIC, such as high solubility and low strength compared to composite, as well as long hardening for at least 24 hours, and at the same time to save its positive properties, ability to release fluorite, which has anti-caries effect, adhesion to the tooth hard tissue without providing an adhesive protocol. How was created such a miracle cement? The filler of GIC and the composite are essentially the same, aluminum silicate glass, and acids are from the same class, polyalkanates. However, the hardening reaction in GIC is the acid base, and in composite, polymerization. In composites, roughly speaking, many similar acids must combine into one large molecule. In other words, to polymerize and then to cross-link with an inorganic filler, for example, with aluminum silicate glass. For details about polymerization and cross-linking, watch one of the previous videos. At acid-based reaction of GIC, the acid does not polymerize, but dissolves the powder particles of aluminum silicate glass and causes the release of fluoride ions, which does not affect the reaction, calcium and aluminum from its surface. Calcium cross-link polyacrylic acid at the beginning of the reaction, giving the cement of working fluid consistency. In 5-7 minutes after mixing, aluminum is connected to the cross-linking. It has 3 links, unlike calcium, which has 2. The cross-linking becomes stronger, and the consistency is harder. Aluminum cross-links slowly, therefore sufficient strength of the GIC is achieved at least 24 hours after fixation. In the compomer, ideally, the polymerization and acid-based reaction should proceed without interfering with each other, forming 2 matrices, which at the end of the reaction are combining. The insertion of the polymer in GIC allows quickly to create frame stiffness that protects the acid-based reaction. However, there is no clear definition of what percentage of composite and GIC should be in compomer. This is used by some manufacturers, giving the usual composite as a compomer. How to define it? The answer is by the instruction. For example, let's take the instruction of random compomer, where it's written that it's a compomer. We read further and stop. It turns out that you need to apply an adhesive system with etching, but the compomer does not need a bond.
James Bond.
It has an adhesion mechanism from the GIC. For the adhesion of the GIC, it is not necessary to etch and dry tissue of the tooth. On the contrary, it is important to maintain the humidity of the hard tissues. When cleaning a tooth with phosphoric acid, the intercollagen layer dissolves, and voids are formed that GIC cannot fill, while the phosphate and calcium ions that are needed for adhesion are washed out. In the case of compomers, you can use the adhesion from the composite matrix, as in the above instructions, but then you need to provide a multi-stage adhesive protocol, and the bond layer will block the diffusion of fluoride. It turns out the meaning of the GIC in the composition is lost. It will only weaken the composite and forcing solubility. Because GIC and tooth tissue have a hydrophilic surface, the cement is evenly distributed on the moist tooth tissue. Hydrogen forms a primary adhesion, which is then enhanced by ionic bonding. The shear bond strength is in the table. The adhesion of the compomer can be enhanced by treating the hard tissues of the tooth with a conditioner. It releases phosphate and calcium ions from the hard tissues, which then linking with the matrix. Ideally, the fixation on compomer should look like this. Almost all types of restorations can be fixed on the compomer, except veneers, due to insufficient adhesion. When fixing ceramics, it is necessary to solanize its surface, and for a better retention of metal restoration, sandblast the surface. As was said earlier, each manufacturer has its own vision of a compomer, and sometimes even requires the use of the bond. Therefore, the data on the physicomechanical parameters and the strength of adhesion vary greatly. Compomer more expensive than the GIC. However, the patient will be able to fully use the restoration as soon as the anesthesia will let you. Thank you all for watching and wishing successful fixation. Write your comments, put likes. Watch us every second Monday. Bye.